Hello everyone, welcome back. This is Ajay and today we are going to understand what exactly is a modem and what it does for us. Okay, so this is how a modem look like. There are many other modems, many types of modems, but this is one of them. And a modem basically is simply used to connect to the internet. In very very simple language, we require a modem to connect to the internet. Okay, that's the first point. So the second point is modem does the work of modulation and demodulation of data. Now what exactly we mean by modulation and demodulation? That is something that we need to understand. Okay, so the first point, as I said, simply we require a modem to connect to the internet and it does the work of modulation and demodulation. Now understand that the data gets carried in form of analog signal, and for that we are using the telephone network. Okay, for transmitting the data from one computer to another computer, when we exchange the data, we make use of this telephone network. Yes, we don't use the telephone anymore, but this network, we are making use of this network for internet, for transmitting the data. Okay, so this telephone network, okay, is very very important for us for the internet purpose. Now this telephone wires basically can carry only and only analog signal, whereas a computer, a general computer, is a digital machine and it has digital signal. So analog signal and digital signal, these are two different signals. Before we understand modulation and demodulation, let us understand these signals first. Analog signal versus digital signal. Now this is how an analog signal looks like. It is a sine waves, okay? And this is how a digital signal looks like. It has a kind of a structure. You can say square structure, okay? So analog signal, okay, is a one type of continuous time varying signal. What it means is that these sine waves, okay, it will kind of change with time and with distance as well. So as long there is a very long wire, so obviously when the data is getting transmitted, this sine waves will be, you know, there will be slight of a change, understand it. And a simple type of analog signal is nothing but a sine wave, as I've told earlier. So this is how an analog signal looks like. Okay, now let's move to the digital signal. Digital signal, it has a particular structure, as I said, and it kind of has a square structure. Okay, so a digital signal represented in the form of 0 and 1. And digital signals are very accurate. So as you can see, the downside over here, okay, that's 0 and the upside is 1, and that's 1 bit. That is how it is calculated. Okay, so understand, 0 represents off and 1 represents on. So on and off, that is how a digital signal works, and that is how a digital machine works. Okay, so these are two different signals, understand it. Now when we make use of the telephone network, the telephone wires basically use analog signal and our computer basically use a digital signal. So there has to be a kind of a translator between these two, right? That is where a modem comes into existence. Okay, so let us take this further. Now what is modulation and demodulation? Okay, suppose this is your computer and you're trying to access a data, you're trying to access a website where the data is present over here in this particular computer. Call this computer as a server machine. So basically you're requesting some kind of data from this particular server. Okay, and this is a remote machine. It is somewhere placed far away. Okay, so what happens is, this particular computer, your computer, is a digital signal, will have a digital signal. So what the modem will do? A modem will convert this digital signal into an analog signal. right? So a digital signal will get converted into analog signal. This process is called as modulation. So the conversion of digital signal into analog signal is called as modulation. Once it is converted into analog signal, now it can easily pass through the telephone wires, through the telephone network, because now it's an analog signal. So obviously it will go to your particular, that particular server machine, but even this server machine is a digital machine. It will not understand this analog signal. So again, the modem will come into action. What the modem will do? The modem will take this analog signal and then convert this into the digital signal, right? And this particular process is called as demodulation. Okay, so this is a reverse back that we're doing. So analog signal again gets converted into digital signal, and then the server machine understands that particular signal. The reverse process will be called as demodulation. And this is called as modulation, and this is called as demodulation. Okay, so this is what the modem does for us. It is very, very important for everywhere where we access the internet somewhere, the modem is playing the role for us. Okay, so now I hope that you exactly know what a modem is, what it does for us, and what is modulation and demodulation. I hope now it's very much clear to you. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed this video, please subscribe to the channel. Bye for now.